Quantitative Study Searching in CINAHL. This video is designed to help you search for primary quantitative studies by using search limiters in the CINAHL database. Let's begin from the library guide designed to support your nursing research course. Many Brightspace course sites provide links to their corresponding library guides, or you can access these guides from the library homepage. From the homepage of this Nursing 390 guide, you'll note several useful tabs on topics such as primary and secondary sources, qualitative studies from a specific journal, and quantitative study searching. This, of course, is the page on which you found the video demo you're watching right now. In order to access the CINAHL database, I'm going to click on the Nursing Databases tab. You can see that the library subscribes to many databases that support nursing research. Today, we'll be using CINAHL Complete for our search. By the way, the letters in the name CINAHL stand for Cumulative Index to Nursing and Allied Health Literature. So the focus of the entire database is on nursing and health topics. You can also access CINAHL and other databases directly from the library homepage. When you access databases from off-campus, you may be prompted to log in with the same info you used to access Brightspace. To demonstrate the breadth of the CINAHL database, I'll do a quick search for a couple of very basic terms. A simple search for nutrition returns over 120,000 articles. And a basic search for fall prevention will net over 11,000 articles. Clearly, this is a very large resource. CINAHL is the most appropriate tool for this assignment because it offers several unique search limiters that can help you meet the requirements of your checklist. In order to view the full range of options, we'll begin by clicking on the Advanced Search link. This page looks very similar to the first basic search page. However, it gives us a set of three stacked search boxes at the top. Usually, you'd begin your search strategy by choosing search terms to type in these fields at the top of the page, much like we do in Google or other search engines. However, because the parameters for choosing an article for this assignment are so specific, we'll begin by focusing on the various search options below. To begin with, your assignment calls for a quantitative research study. Most databases don't have a reliable method to distinguish between quantitative and qualitative research. It would be easy if we could just type in the word quantitative in the search box above, but unfortunately, most research studies don't actually contain the word quantitative. If that seems puzzling to you, think of it this way. When you pick up a book to read, it might be fiction, like Harry Potter, or nonfiction, like a textbook. But the book will almost never use the words fiction or nonfiction, right? So searching for the word quantitative is not going to be productive here. Although CINAHL can't help us separate quantitative from qualitative, it does provide us with a checkbox to limit our search results to a research article. As you know, primary research studies typically contain section headings like objective, methods, results, data analysis, and conclusions. Checking this research box will help eliminate items that are merely informative articles, secondary reports, commentary, etc. We can also check a box to limit our search to articles in English. Your assignment checklist may also specify that our article should be peer-reviewed. So here's another good checkbox to use. Peer-reviewed journals require their articles to be reviewed by experts in the field prior to publication. Another criteria mentioned in your checklist is that the study sample should use human subjects, so we can include this checkbox. Your assignment also specifies that the study you select should have a nurse as the first author. CINAHL is the only database I know that has a checkbox for that. One note of caution. If the date range for your assignment is 1 year or less, I'd have to recommend that you avoid using this checkbox. There's often some lag time between the date that newly published studies are entered into the CINAHL database and when the indexing of details such as the author's credentials get it added. So using this limiter for date ranges of less than 1 year may find very few results. But if your date range is more than 1 year, it should prove very useful. If we want our study to come from a nursing journal, we can use this journal subset box to specify that we only want to look at nursing journals. And perhaps the most useful option here is the one that allows us to limit our search by date. Different courses and sometimes even different sections of the same course will use different date ranges in their assignment checklist. So please review your checklist for the class to ensure that you're entering the appropriate dates for your assignment. For purposes of this example, I'm going to use a 5-year date range of 2015 to 2020. Once you've finished choosing your search limiters, you're ready to type in search terms. But first, I'm going to click the search button without entering any search terms at all, just to see how much our limiters have already narrowed our search. You can see that out of more than 1 million articles in the CINAHL database, the criteria we've entered, which I see displayed over in the left margin, have already narrowed the pool of potential articles to about 4,000. And of course, not all of these articles will meet the assignment criteria. Some may be qualitative or mixed method studies. At this time, you can begin browsing the list to find a research study that fits the other parameters of your assignment. Or you can try typing in a few broad search terms to find an article of interest. For example, I'll enter the term nutrition. Recall that there were over 120,000 articles relating to nutrition in the database when I did a sample search at the beginning of this video. Of those 120,000 articles, there are now only 92 that meet the search criteria we've entered so far. Similarly, we performed a sample search for fall prevention and found over 11,000 articles. Entering that same concept now, I find only 46 potential studies for fall prevention. So our search parameters, which are still displayed there on the left side, have dramatically narrowed the field of articles you could use for your assignment. When you examine a list of results, you'll see a brief description immediately below the article title in blue. Here you find the author names, the title of the journal that the article was published in, the date, volume, issue, page number, etc. For most articles, you'll also see a PDF full text icon. Clicking on this icon should open the article for you in full text. Here you'll see the full text article, including any photos, charts, graphs, tables, etc. Some articles, however, will not have the PDF icon, but instead offer you the option to check for full text availability. Some journal publishers place copyright restrictions on the full text availability, and if CINAHL doesn't have full text access to an article, it's offering to search across other databases at Purdue to see if it can find the article for you elsewhere. Clicking on that check for full text option may provide you with a link that will open the article for you. In this case, the CINAHL database is pointing us to a link in the Journals at Ovid database. Clicking on the link in blue will take us to the article's main page. Here, I'll look for the red and white PDF icon that will display the full text of the article for us. There are times, however, when CINAHL will not be able to provide a link to the article you're seeking. In my experience, this works about 50% of the time. As you begin scanning through the articles you found, a good tip to remember is that CINAHL keeps track of your search history for you. By clicking on the Search History link, you can see all of your previous searches. From our initial search, S1, and working upward, the list shows our search terms in the first column, our search criteria, such as date range and human subjects here, and this column shows the number of results. You can easily return to a previous search from here. This is handy because you may try several topics before you decide on a study that meets all the criteria and sparks your interest. Let's do a couple of other quick searches. How about hand washing? It looks like there are 18 articles that fit our criteria. Let's try opioids. We have 30 articles to choose from. Many people like to begin with a broad search term and then narrow their search by stages. I'm going to try adding the term addiction to my search for opioids. Eventually, your search results may become too small. Here we only have 2 articles, so we might need to go back a step or two to get the best results. I'm going to use the search history to return to our list for articles on nutrition. And then I'll collapse the search history. Another of the main specifications in your article's checklist is that the study you choose should be a primary study. This means that the article is written by the actual researchers who designed and performed this experiment. Just as in the case of quantitative versus qualitative, there's no easy checkbox to limit your search to primary versus secondary research. You'll need to make that determination yourself. But a great tip is to look for headings that are frequently used in primary research studies, with terms like objective, methods, results, conclusions, etc. The assignment checklist also instructs you to avoid systematic reviews since they are not primary research. One way to recognize these articles is to examine the citation information immediately below the article title. Here we see the authors, the title of the journal this article appears in, the date, volume, issue, etc. A brief description of the article appears in parentheses. You'll need to avoid using any articles where the description includes the term systematic review. Once you've selected an article that meets all the requirements, you'll need to save the full text in PDF format and submit it via Brightspace. I hope this has provided some helpful tips for finding a primary quantitative study that will meet the criteria of your checklist. Librarians have been specifically asked not to help you determine whether an article is quantitative or qualitative, but I think there's enough information in your course readings and here on the Nursing 390 LibGuide to point you in the right direction. Good luck with your assignment. My contact information is on the homepage of your LibGuide. And as you continue with other assignments, remember that additional video instructions are available on the Video Tutorials tab. Thank you.